Hi friends, my name is Chaitanya Patke and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to take a look at the 7 T20 International which took place at the Gaddafi Stadium in Lahore between England and Pakistan. England won a historic series by a 4-3 margin, a thrilling series. The end was a bit of a dampener because England won all too easily, I would say, with all due respect to the Pakistani side. But all in all, there are a lot of positives for Pakistan as well, as we know that after a gap of 17 long years that the English team has visited the Pakistani shores, and it will definitely give confidence to other teams as well to visit Pakistan. England were accorded VIP security, that was rightfully so, and yes, cricket, actually live cricket is returning back to normalcy in Pakistan, so that's a good thing. Pakistan won the toss, which is very crucial, and they chose to bowl first. England managed a competitive, I would say more than competitive in the end, it turned out to be 209 for 3 in their allotted 20 overs. Phil Salt scored 20 of 12 deliveries, which includes three boundaries. He was undone by a magnificent run out by Shadab Khan, but he was looking very good. Alex Hale scored 18 of 13, which also includes three boundaries. So both of the English openers got the start, but couldn't continue. Hasnain eventually got out Alex Hale by a lovely ball, which Alex Hale actually couldn't do much about it. It was a fantastic in-swinger. David Malan scored the best innings of this tour for himself, that is 78 of 47 deliveries, which includes 8 boundaries and 3 massive sixes at a strike rate of 165.96. As we know that he looked into the groove in the last game, but couldn't make it count, but in this game he made merry. So if you analyze David Malan's batting in this series, in the first 5 games he actually looked to hit the ball too hard, which is not his natural strength, but he returned to timing in the 6th one, and in this game he his cover drives were there for all to see. He's equally good off the pads as well. He has lovely wrists. He is unlike English batsman because his wrists remind us of the Indian batsman from the subcontinent, and scored all round the ground, played the pull shot and hook shot to perfection as well, and Pakistani bowler in short had no answer for his brilliance. We know, you know that it is the same David Malan that has actually kept Joe Root out of the T20 squad, so his talent cannot be doubted at all, but he just needed this score to up his confidence level as well. Ben Duckett scored 30 of 19 deliveries, which also includes 3 boundaries and a massive 6. He looked very much at home, swept and reverse-swept in this game as well. Unfortunate to get out at the wrong moment, he was run out by Mohammad Rizwan, and Harry Brook, rightfully adjudged the man of the series in the final game, also showed his immense potential and talent. 46 of 29 deliveries, which includes a boundary and 4 massive 6 over the ground, peppered all areas of the ground, especially towards the covers as well as towards cow corner and mid wicket, and Pakistani bowlers once again were caught napping due to his brilliance. In Mohammad Nawaz, in one over, gave away 12 runs, was quite expensive. Mohammad Hasnain is under a decent figure, he accounted for Alex Hale's 4 overs, 32 runs, a single wicket. Mohammad Wasim was the most expensive of them all, 15.25 runs per overs. In 4 overs, gave away 61 runs. He was all over the place, didn't find his length. And with the kind of form that David Malan and Harry Brooks was, nothing can be done, unfortunately. He has to learn quickly for his own good as well as for Pakistan's. Haris Rauf was the lone bright light in this lackluster display for Pakistan. In 4 overs, gave away 24 runs, bowled his cutters, bouncers to perfection, and yes, other Pakistani bowlers will be well off if they look to emulate Haris Rauf. Shadab Khan, the vice captain, had a disappointing outing as well. 3 overs, gave away 39 runs. He lacked control. He was either too short or too full, which the English batsman took full advantage of. And Iftikhar Ahmed, as we know, that has been bowling consistently well, but in this game, he was actually wicketless in the previous games as well, but his economy rate was below 7 or sometimes 6.5 to 6 as well. But in this game, 4 overs, 34 runs, no wicket, so not much contribution from the ball from Iftikhar. Pakistan set a mammoth total of 210, that too the pressure of a series decider crumbled. After the top order had a rare failure, collective failure I would say, Mohammad Rizwan for a single and Babar Azam for a 4. Mohammad Rizwan was undone by a ripper by Rhys Topley, and any batsman in the world could have been out of that for that delivery. Chris Woakes accounted for Babar Azam. Harry Brook took a splendid catch. So as we know that Pakistani middle order has been their Achilles heel. Shaan Masood scored 56, but that came off 43 deliveries, 4 boundaries and a 6. He was undone by Woakes as well. Rashid took a catch in the deep. This innings actually done nobody any favour. Not even Shaan Masood would have liked this innings. He struggled all the way through, and when they target is 210, you cannot take 43 deliveries of 56. Iftikhar Ahmed scored 19 of 16. He was undone by David Willey. Actually hit 3 boundaries and looked quite good, but once again the same old problem with the Pakistani middle order, that they don't convert their starts into the big scores, which is a huge problem for them. Khushdil Shah once again a lackluster innings, 27 of 25 deliveries, not at an appropriate strike rate at all when you are chasing 210, a boundary and a 6. He was undone by Adil Rashid, a simple stumping for Phil Salt. Asif Ali, the guy who practices 150 sixes daily, couldn't hit even one in this game, 7 of 9. Once again, Chris Woakes bringing all his experience to the fore. So, yes, Khushdil Shah, Asif Ali, Iftikhar Ahmed, not good at all. Mohammad Nawaz scored 9 of 9 deliveries. Sam Curran accounted for his wicket. But as we know that Mohammad Nawaz has played a couple of crucial innings for Pakistan in this series as well as against India. So, no need to judge him harshly. Mohammad Wasim, 5. David Willey, undone. He was out by undone. Coming to English bowlers, Woakes, 4 overs, 26 for 3. Wonderful. Rhys Topley, 4 overs, 34 for 1. Willey in 4 overs gave away 22 runs and took 2 wickets. Rashid 4 over 25, magnificent control. Ali 1 over 5. And Karan also bowled wonderfully well towards the death. 3 overs, 27 runs, 1 wicket. So all in all, a lackluster display by Pakistan, and England won by 67 runs. Harry Brook, the man of the series, and man of the match was David Malan for his 78. So how did you like my analysis of the 70-20? Please tell in the comment section below, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel and press the bell icon for further notifications. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, everyone, bye, and humbly requesting once again to you all, please subscribe.